My wife did it. It wasn't me. How many times have we heard that? But that is apparently the story that WSA Channel 9 is reporting, that Derric Simms, the 45-year-old substitute teacher at Glen Burnie High School on Friday, who at about 2:15 p.m. had his backpack searched. He left the backpack, apparently, in a room while he was someplace else. Backpack was searched anonymously. Somebody said, look into that thing. And they found a gun, loaded weapon, in there. And now he's facing seven charges. The update, we talked about this before, just to update the story. Right. He's facing seven charges, including firearm possession with a criminal violent history conviction, having a dangerous weapon on school property, illegal possession of a handgun, and four other gun-related charges. He's facing, Bryan, 30 years in prison totally. But at the end of the day, while we can talk about his wife, a lot of people ask the questions that I ask, Bryan. How in the world did he pass a background check?
I don't know. These are the questions that really need to be answered more than anything else. Is like, how was this guy able to become a substitute teacher if he's had these problems in the back? Now, they said before that the gun charge that he had from 1999 would not have prevented him from being a substitute.
But it wasn't just that. He had other charges as well. And the totality of those charges should have appeared. Like I say, when you are doing a background check, it's not just whether you can own a gun, you know, but when you become a teacher, you look at all of this. You just don't look at one thing. You look at everything.
Right. So he was charged with having a gun in 1999. He was also charged with a marijuana possession. He also got charged with a controlled substance. He also was arrested for an alcohol violation, open container type situation. So he has all of that on his record in the
last 15
years.
Makes him a great teacher, doesn't
it? I don't know. Is that enough?
Yes.
Is that not enough to be able to teach?
No, it's not. You need to not be able to. You can do other jobs, but not be with children. That's what the parents at Glen Burnie High are upset. Right. They've been talking to the media. They want to talk to Principal Kevin Carr, who's the principal at the school there, to figure out what happened.
I got to tell you, I don't put this on the principal. What is the principal supposed to do? The principal is supposed to do the investigation himself.
No,
this
he's
guy
supposed
has
to
been
find
cleared
out who
by
didn't
the
do
state.
It. But who didn't do it? Principal, you find out what happened. You're
well,
the leader of the school.
Here's what I would say. I'd say go ask Annapolis. The state board of education or whoever is in
it's
control
the
of
Anne Arundel
this,
County of the, Board of County, Education.
I know, that's what I mean. The Anne Arundel County Board of Education, which is in Annapolis, to go ask them why this guy passed the background check. All I'm asking for is, did he pass the background check? He passed the background check. We need substitute teachers. He's good enough to go. Well, then let's hire
until
him.
Something like this happens. And the point is that there has to be a little more due diligence. And I understand you have a need, and a lot of people are saying get as many bodies in classrooms as you can to teach. But something like this happens when you aren't checking every dot and every I,
the principals
every
don't
team.
Have enough time to do this. Why you
right,
have
they're
background
in charge
checks.
Of the school.
See, Ford, they pay past the
what do you
background
mean
check.
Their job is to oversee teachers and administrators. That's their job.
And so their job is to go and do background checks
Mr.
of everyone
Simms,
who they
come
hire.
Let me talk to you. Who are you? Their job is to know.
And
every...
what's he going
to
tell you? Oh, let me tell you. Back in 2007, I was smoking pot outside. Cops came and arrested
Look,
me. He's not going to say
the
that.
The principal's job at the school is to know every employee at that school, upwards and downwards. That's their job. I'm why they get paid $200,000, whatever they get paid.
You're honestly being ridiculous
if
you're going to put that on the principal when the guy passed a federal and state background.
Said, what is he supposed to do?
What is he supposed to do?
He's supposed to know every employee, substitute teacher, everybody else, and say, look, Mr. Simms, let's check on you, make sure everything's okay.
I'm sure he was interviewed for the job. I'm sure it probably lasted about five
minutes.
I am
not blaming the principal. You asked me a direct question, what is he supposed to do?
Yes.
And then the principal is supposed to go to Anne Arundel County's school board, whatever, and say, why didn't you guys do whatever?
Yeah.
And then go back to his school and tell him what happened.
That's exactly what I would say to them. I go, how did this guy pass the background check. I was told that he was good to go, and if I've been told that he's good to go, then I'm going to hire him if he's qualified, which he was qualified
then
to do.
Then he should ask for heads to roll because he was given incorrect information.
Well, maybe he is. Maybe he is.
What
By the way, the
out?
Judge in the case yesterday, because he was before a judge, allowed him to go home. Now, again, he's not charged with, like, a massive serious crimes, but bringing a gun to school is a pretty serious crime. Now, he told police investigators that he thinks maybe his wife put the gun in his bag.
Honey did it.
You're going to believe
Honey
that.
Honey did it.
But here's
what?
And what we're also being told is he left the bag in a classroom and went to another classroom. So somebody was in the classroom where he left the bag and was trying to find out whose bag it was to give it back to them. And as they were rummaging through the bags to try to find out the identity, sees the gun, calls the school resource officer. Whole school gets locked down. They trace it back to the substitute teacher. He gets arrested. So that's kind of how this whole all thing went
down.
He
also told officers, according to WSA Channel 9, he told officers the gun was registered to him in North Carolina and that his wife may have placed it. The problem is he's prohibited from owning a firearm. Right. So he couldn't have owned it.
Okay, so
he lied to officers.
All right, so he's been released back to his family. He's got a wife and kids, apparently lives in Baltimore. The judge in the case said, my job is to clear the dust, not get caught in the emotion of what could have happened. What could have happened is grave, serious, and problematic, and the facts of this are egregious in that nature. What did happen was that the handgun was found, and there was no indication that it was going to be used against anyone, so he sent him home.
But they had charged him with a significant charge. I don't have a problem with them sending him home because really he's preparing for court. I have a problem with that. I do have a problem, though, and this to me should be a blinking red light for all school systems. I know you need teachers. I get it. You're trying to get as many adults to teach as possible. Check their backgrounds. Don't count on whatever the state or whatever did for a background check. If you could pull it up online, so could these schools pull it up online to see this guy's background to determine whether he should be a teacher or not.
Isn't that what we pay for these background checks
absolutely.
to figure that out?
And they slip through, and sometimes people slip through, as we're seeing here.
Right.
As we're seeing.
So the principal of a school can say, I'm not going to hire you because you had a probation before judgment marijuana case.
They can tell anybody you're
there.
Not coming into my school. Doesn't matter whether you had, they can not, you don't have to be a substitute teacher. The principal can say, no, you're not coming in here. Okay. I don't like what color pants you wear.
Right.
You're not coming in here.
That's what we're going to do now. And if you have any kind of criminal past, we're not going to allow you to teach ever?
If you have this type of, I'm going to take a case-by-case basis. If the litany of things you went down, no, you can't come into my school with what you read about this guy Simms.
Even though it was 15 years ago?
You can do something else. I'm sure that McDonald's has a wonderful management position down the street. You can't teach. No, you can't teach with that.
Because of what?
Because of the drug possession.
The drug possession
the
is a big problem, even though marijuana is legal
alcohol
now.
Alcohol possession. Okay, now. It wasn't then.
Right, but it is now.
But it wasn't then.
We're supposed to forgive everybody of all the marijuana
sins. You'd be in the forgiveness stage.
That's what the law says.
I'm not the law. I'm running a school. Schools aren't bound by your progression of logic.
I just think that you're being way too hard on the principal here.
I'm being
the principal
hard because
was given
kids.
The thumbs up by the state in the federal background check. You expect that person to be okay.
And
if they did okay in the interview, you hire them.
Principals to be aware of their employees and anybody else, any other parent. That's why parents, I'm not the only one, parents are going after the principal as well.
I think the parents are probably more upset with the system than they are the principal.
Well, they're going after the principal.